Hello, Lilas. So I'm here with Baby Noah, and Baby Noah is the Willow Kit by Claire Teller. He is actually the prototype number 2. And guys, if you're already watching this video, go ahead and make sure that you subscribe to my channel. You by clicking the red subscribe button, and you can give this video a thumbs up if you like. Make sure you leave me a comment below. I read all my comments. And if you want to be a part of the chatterbox, you can do so by joining, by clicking the link in the description bar. It is $4.99 to join. That's once a month. And what else? You have to be at least 18 years old or older to join. Anyway, back to Baby Noah. So today I'm just going to do a simple changing video of him. I just want to show you guys. I don't get it. I'll zoom in a little later, but I just want to make sure that you guys can see him. And he's been sleeping. I'm just going to put him on something simple because it's been so hot. And there was a night where it was cool. It was cool in the house, so I put him on something a little bit more warmer. But now that it is warm, it's going to be warm all day. I am going to go ahead and get him into something warm. I sat and held him last night, I was just trying to distract myself and from other things, and just sitting in my rocker, rocking and thinking, and he is a good distraction. But definitely getting to see the benefit of the weight of these dolls, where they say that they can be therapeutic in that way. I'm not a doctor or anything like that, so I'm just telling you what I've read and heard, and just the feeling that they give. Mostly, I think most people collect them for the realism and mostly just the look of them, with the silicone, more of a feel. Dressing and all that good stuff. I love taking photos of them and stuff like that. It feels a little surreal to actually have him here. And I don't know, for a lot of you guys that have been following me for a long time, you may or may not know, but I have been wanting a sleeping boy for a long time. Or I'm not gonna say a sleeping boy necessarily. I prefer a sleeping boy, but I probably would have been okay with awake. But I wanted me another African American baby, AA, black, whatever you decide to, how you decide to describe it. Some people get offended by different terms, but I've been wanting a true AA baby in silicone for a while, and it's just been hard to come by. And so it's like such a dream, because there's so many things about him that, you know, he's all in one piece. Oh, sorry. Sorry about that. He's all in one piece. He's all in one piece. I don't have a cold. I think my sinuses or something is messing with me. But yeah,
being all in one piece and a sleeper is definitely a plus, because when I decide to start doing outing videos and stuff like that, it is so much easier to take a sleeper out than an awake baby. So I like that. And it's almost like I'm getting the best of both worlds, because he is a big baby, so he can fit into a lot of different clothes. His clothes selection is not as limited as a newborn, but yet he has that very newborn look to him. So it's kind of like you get the best of both worlds, and I'm really, really enjoying that. I haven't fully shopped for him. I ordered him some things that came, and it was just a special treat to him or myself, whichever way you want to put it. But I will be shopping for him, definitely shopping for him, so that he can have his own clothes. I'm gonna designate his own space for his own clothes, just that he doesn't share. But I gotta have the time to do that. This is a newborn t-shirt that I'm putting him on. Like I said, he can fit, it's so sad, look at him. Oh my gosh. And then he just wrinkles all up. It's just so cute. He can fit newborn like t-shirts or onesies, as long as it's not long sleeves, because his arms are, you know, chubby or got a little fat to them. I wouldn't recommend putting this baby in a newborn long sleeve onesie, just because you have to really work to get it in there, and that leaves room for accidents and damages. So I know a lot of times my little hands be so ashy, but I wash my hands every time before I interact with my dolls, and I don't lotion them, because I don't want the oil to get on the dolls. Because again, at the end of the day, as much as we call them babies, they are painted. And I just don't think the oils are good for them. So I just don't do it. I was looking like right here, he had like his, it's so crazy, like his, the way he's painted and the way that it wrinkles on him, like, I don't know. I think you have to see it in person because it don't pick up on camera, but it just looks like, it really looks like skin, and it feels like skin. Like this time, his, the texture on him is different. I don't know how to explain it. But yeah, it's different, and it feels more real than the last one that I had. Like every time they just, I'm not gonna say more real, like because like Taylor felt really nice, she had a really nice feel and stuff like that. I'm just gonna say that it just feels different. I'm not gonna say more real, but it feels different. It's like every baby that I've gotten from Claire Taylor has been different. Like I've not had two babies that's painted with the same technique.
like they are painted all so different, which is pretty cool. And these are some little socks. I did get these. They are little polo socks, but for Ralph Lauren. They were on sale. So that's the only reason I got them, because I don't see the point of spending top dollar for just plain baby socks when they're going to get covered up by their clothes usually and stuff. And to be honest, I don't even care for the way they fit, because they're baggy up in the ankle part. Like, they're stretchy. Like, I don't know. They're not. I don't know. So I don't even care for the way they fit over the cheaper socks. So yeah, but I did get them because they matched the outfit that he had, and they were on sale. So I said, you know what, I'm gonna get them. But now that I have them, I don't like them. Not a whole lot. So he'll wear them under his clothes for sure. And that's about it. But yeah, so he like can pose in like all these different ways. It's pretty cool. I like that. I really like that. There's a lot of times where when I'm taking photographs and stuff, normally I have to prop the babies and stuff like that. But with Noah pretty much will lay in any position almost and stay. His hands and stuff, usually you can just lay them however you want to lay them and they'll stay. So I really love the elbow armatures. I was a little unsure with the elbow armatures when I had Bella. And then when I got Taylor, I really liked them in Taylor. And then I really liked them in him. So I'm deciding that I would probably prefer elbow armatures, or no armatures at all. But I really think I would prefer the elbow armatures. And the reason being is how I don't know which way his arms are truly sculpted without the armature stretching them out. But even though with armatures, I think you will still without armatures, you'll have a lot of posability with a baby. Like, they can lay their arms up and you know, down and, you know, out like that. And I think you'll be able to still stretch them a lot. So I like the without, but I like the armatures with, because it allows them to hold, you know, more of a sometime when he's not playing around, a straight pose or something like that. So I think they with without, all of it kind of works, to be honest. It just depends on what you like to do. I take a lot of photos, so some type of armature works really good for me. It's so crazy, this is how it goes. So originally I had a full body baby that didn't have any armatures, and I loved it. And then they didn't have a squishy tummy. Then I wanted a baby with squishy tummy. So I got a baby with squishy tummy, but that baby didn't have armatures. Then I decided that, you know what, I want a baby with squishy tummy and armatures. So I got a baby with squishy tummy and armatures in both the arms and the legs. And then I decided, you know what, I want a baby without the armatures. And then I did that. And then the baby is like, it's crazy. So it's like you're always wanting something that you don't have or whatever. But I did find a great love for armatures and babies once I did use them. Sometimes the whole shoulder armatures is a little more rigid. But, you know, if you don't like your babies to really do a lot of dangling and stuff like that, then, you know, the armatures will keep them, you know, falling without the hands dangling and stuff like that. So, you know, like I said, they're both really nice. It's good to have options and, you know, have what you know, be able to make a decision if you like them or don't like them.
So, I don't know. It was something else I was going to tell you guys, too. Anyway, but I think that's it. His thighs is chunky, too. What was it? It was something else I was going to tell you guys. Oh, well. I'll talk to you guys later. I can't think of it right now. As soon as I shut the camera off, I'm going to remember. But I don't want to stress my mind too much.